We've just heard from three really terrific private firms, but as I said at the beginning, in addition to having such a great design community here, we also have an incredible corporate community and nonprofit community, and our next speaker is in some ways a representative of both. Anna Lee is a technical designer at Target Corporation, who has been a very good friend of our college, as well as of the university, and she's a Minneapolis-based milliner and designer with, as she says, a heart for community and a mind for industry development of the independent fashion design community here in the Twin Cities. And because of that, she has been a founder of MN Fashion, an emerging nonprofit that works to provide resources and opportunities for independent designers in the Twin Cities. She's also served as a producer of Voltage Fashion Amplified, which is an annual rock and roll fashion show promoting the hottest independent designers and musicians in the Twin Cities. So please welcome Anna Lee. Anna.
As Tom mentioned, my name is Anna Lee. I am, let's see here, I'm a technical designer by day, hat designer or milliner by night, and producer, instigator, and community organizer by reputation. And I'm learning how to own my blank space. So what is blank space? To an entrepreneur, it could be opportunity, untapped resources, potential for the future. To the spiritual or philosophical, it could be peace, nothingness, or enlightenment. But to the artist, it is a blank canvas or the unused open space within a composition that could create a balanced work of art. But the blank space I want to talk about this evening is terrifying and powerful. It's this. It's the who am I? It's the 3 a.m. why am I even attempting to do this with my life? It's the part of a project we avoid because we have no clue how we're going to finish it. It's the I'll never have a brilliant idea ever again. It's irrational, it's empty and void, and we've all felt it, and we all work so hard to fill it. The first time I remember feeling anything even remotely close to this was Christmas of 1992. I was 15 and hanging out with my family. I was bored and consumed with the idea that I was supposed to be doing something more important with my time. Although what 15-year-old doesn't feel that around the holidays with their family? But for some reason, I made my uncle aware of my boredom, and he said something that had a profound impact on the next 20 years of my life. And he said, "Only boring people get bored, Anna." So I was angry about this for a minute, but in that moment, I realized three things. I realized that I had some sort of responsibility for my own entertainment, that my attitude and actions could have a direct impact on my engagement with the world. And finally, that the blank space is boring and a little scary, and only boring people get bored. So quick, get interesting, and really fast. So by the time I was a senior in high school, I was showing my artwork regularly in Fargo, North Dakota, of all places, and even selling some of it. I'm a firm believer in our ability to create our own realities, and it is the, I feel at least, the ultimate artistic expression, aside from creating life, of course. But when I moved to Minneapolis in the year 2000, I knew approximately three people, not including relatives, and I had the blank canvas version of blank space. I said yes to absolutely everything, designing modern dance costumes, painting, starting my millinery career, making clothing out of paper, and wild headdresses. There are a lot more photos of my projects than I could show in this evening, but this one really represents a moment in time. In 2005, when I was transitioning into a community leader of sorts, this photo shoot was for the very first issue of L'Etoile magazine. I don't know if any of you are familiar with it. It's now an online resource for fashion and the arts in the Twin Cities. And it had a brief stint as a print publication, and this was from the very first photo shoot. I was in the midst of the second year of production on Voltage Fashion Amplified, which is started in 2004. And as Tom mentioned, that's a rock and roll fashion show, which was also a design incubator and fundraiser for MN Fashion, the nonprofit I founded to develop the burgeoning fashion industry in the Twin Cities. I saw a blank space that needed to be filled. We weren't connected as designers. If we didn't band together, we risked early burnout and worse, obsolescence. So fast forward to 2010. We were growing as an organization, having an impact on people's careers, and we had a semblance of industry. It was really gratifying and exciting, and yet, let's see here, this, I missed a slide. And yet I felt this. Nothing was gonna make this comfortable or go away, ever. I was going to have to learn how to embrace that blank space. So I started handing over most of my projects in the fall of 2010 and focused on redefining how I was gonna fill this space. This, of course, is a super simplified version of the story. It's very neat and tied in a bow right now. but what is it that we gain from filling our blank space? You know, we gain meaning, expression, connection, a sense of worth. We gain distraction from boredom. A full, very important schedule with a really important to-do list. And I'm sure you guys can all think of other things to add to this. But what do we lose? And I think that's like the most important thing for us to think about when we find ourselves really busy. Because there's absolutely nothing wrong with being busy and all of the things we fill our lives with. In fact, the fact that we have the ability to consciously decide how we fill our lives is a very beautiful thing. But what we lose is a sense of patience and peace, that all is well with the world, that all is well with ourselves. We lose an understanding that we have worth no matter what we do or don't do with our lives, and the ability to sit with that blank space allows us to the chance to catch our creative breath, revive, and know with great confidence that we are going to have another brilliant idea just around the corner. Thank you.
That was great. I think one of the things I've always enjoyed about this event is that it makes me realize that design generally is as much a way of life as it is an activity, and I think you hear that in our speakers tonight.